somebody's product, there's a lot of people that have the tendency to want to change to the next album.
Okay. Yeah.
And that's the thing where you just have to accept that you're the orange person, and there's the brown person, and there's the blue person. And when people want the orange, you'll be the one picking. It's just one of those things. We can't have it all. So you know, I have tried and been part of something in early in my career of changing, like the weather. And it's probably one of the worst feelings there is when you look back at it. So, another part that I decided to do in 96 was that I was going to do my music. I was going to be me 24 hours a day. I write about me, the way I see the world, the way I feel that day, the way I felt yesterday, where I'm going, where I've been, and all in between. So I don't ever have to sit there with pen and paper or the guitar and have to invent anything. It's simply just an extension of myself, good or bad. And I'll take the criticism and stuff like that, because I'm not going to be anything but myself.
And that's what I've always really appreciated about your solo career. And I was, Mike, I was fortunate enough to get to see you play a few times with White Lion back in the day. And I was really looking forward to catching your show with Firehouse here in Milwaukee on the 15th. On these shows, are you doing mostly your solo work, or are you throwing in some of the White Lion songs along with them?
Well, here's actually the surprise, if it is a surprise, because this is something that obviously has followed me since the end of 91 when I ended White Lion. And then, you know, is sometimes, you know, in the late 90s when I started going back out on the road and playing from time to time, people were always asking my age and stuff like, is he playing any White Lion stuff like that? And I would show up at the venues, and some places, the club went as far as putting White Lion plays here tonight.
Oh, man.
You know, there's just some people that will go that, you know. So I've had to live with that. Once I started doing my solo show, meaning just me and the acoustic guitar traveling around, you know, my set was 50-50. And I always remembered where I came from and stuff like that. And I always wanted to get, but I just wasn't promoting it that way. I thought that, you know, the fans would know me well enough that, you know, I've written all the songs. So when I stand out there and play a song, I don't necessarily look at it as being a White Lion song or my tram solo song. The songs come from the same guitar and the same fingers, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Now, I'm releasing this new album, but the tour is basically called The Songs of White Lion. So it's a two-hour, 100% vintage classic White Lion. In, of course, you know, it's me and another guitar player on electric guitar. We got a little bit of some drum loops behind. So we're taking these classic songs into, like, a new place, which basically makes you feel quite comfortable, because it's not a rehash of 80s style, but more about the songs that fits in with where I am today. I mean, I'm going up there, 59 years old, singing and presenting the songs current. I'm here today. This is the moment I'm in.
Excellent.
It's not yesterday, et cetera, et cetera. This is where I am. And a lot of the fans who come have seen the shows really appreciate, you know, these, you know, down to the ground kind of versions of the classic White Lion songs. And I've actually enjoyed playing them this way, because I always said that I would never go out and try to do White Lion full band and the old style, because that was me back then. That's not me today.
Well, with the toll that the coronavirus is now taking on live music around the world, Mike, do you see yourself rescheduling these dates that have had been canceled so far? Or are you thinking about maybe doing the U.S. later this year, next year?
Yeah. I'm sorry that we didn't get into that, and maybe there hasn't been enough. It's only because we've been waiting a little. It's like, you know, give the people a break. Give everybody just a break. I mean, you know, it's like everybody is flooding everybody. We're moved the entire tour starting August 26th till October 5th.
Nice.
So the whole tour, almost the whole tour. Actually, I had to cut it short because I'm committed in October and November and December in Europe. So, yes, if everything goes well, crossing my fingers, we're starting on the 26th in L.A., and we'll work our way up there. And I did see the date for Milwaukee. I just can't remember it right off of my hand, you know.
Outstanding. Well, you know, another thing I wanted to talk to you about is I see that on your website you're taking pre-orders for a second time around, and I see that you also got it available in vinyl. Now, I'm a huge fan of vinyl because I like to hold something in my hand when I'm listening to music. I don't know.
I like that, yeah.
I just do, whether it be a CD or vinyl. I was one of those kids who read all the liner notes and all the lyrics and stuff. And yeah. I see that you have both those options available for fans to pre-order.
Yeah. Last year, I released it on cassette tapes too.
Wow.
You know what? I'm nostalgic to the T's, man. It's simply as that. I mean, obviously, it's not groundbreaking anymore. Almost every artist that have a little bit of respect for themselves does a limited amount of 180 gram colored vinyl or something else. And I'm pleased that you said holding something. I mean, you weren't necessarily just saying something that sounds different or something like that. It's exactly the way I feel, and I always talk about it during the show and from the stage, that there was a time that, you know, when you went to the record store and the guy or the woman behind the counter actually was an expert in the field, and you got into a conversation and it's, oh man, if you like this, I got something for you. And, you know, that suddenly just disappeared. And then you just went in there and, you know, nobody behind the counter just, like, you know, took your money and then sit out. But this thing about coming back with the vinyl is about that, recreating that feeling, and I put a lot of work into the artwork and the feeling of holding it, you know, the quality of the paper and everything like that, everything, you know. So I'm just not ready to roll over and die. I want to remember the days when I fell in love with rock and roll, and it has to do with that whole scenario of going to a store, you know, buying something, carrying it home, you know. And the interesting thing about vinyl, it's like opening a bottle of wine, you let it breathe for a little bit. It's like there's a preparation. I'm going to listen to music now. It's going to take about 2 or 3 minutes to prepare that. You know, you have a different kind of appreciation of it after you're excited about it, and you start, your heart starts beating. How, you know, you're not just like just pressing steam or a playlist or something like that, scratching your ass and you know, hey, I'm barely breathing. Everything is on automatic. No, you at that moment you're actually thinking. You're actually alive. You know.
Amen to that. Now, Mike, I've got one final question for you. We do our show here in Wisconsin, and the question is, if you could go back through your solo releases or even the White Lion catalog, is there a song that you think that could have used more cowbell?
Yeah, well, you know, probably. It's just one of those things that I have a sound man that has an hour and a half pre-show music, and every song has cowbell.
That's awesome.
You got to do something these days.
That is awesome. Well, Mike, we want to thank you for joining us today, and you are welcome back here anytime on Rock and Metal Revival, and we're really looking forward to this album second time around coming out.
It's my pleasure, man. And you know what? All the power to the fans out there, man. They're the ones keeping rock and roll alive.
There's the Michael Schenker Group in Victim of Illusion on Rock and Metal Revival. And, hey, dude, next week going to join us on the show is Mitch Perry. And didn't he play with Schenker? I know he played with, like, everybody once.
Yeah,
you know?
Schenker. He was with Schenker for the Macaulay Schenker era, I think. He with the long fake hair extension. When Michael had long fake hair extensions. And
oh, yeah, okay.
Like, anytime. That song, Anytime, and
okay,
that album.
Perfect Timing?
Yeah, he was on a couple of their albums, I think. And yeah, great guitar player, and he was with Talis, and I saw him with Talis back at the club in, where was it, Fort Atkinson?
Oh, The Rock?
Back in the day, the little some sunken sub.
Okay, I know that.
Yeah. I saw Talis there back in the day. They were pretty badass.
Well, he played with Lita Ford. I think he played with Rat.
Yeah, great.
Aerosmith.
Great guitar player.
Yeah, and he's got a new solo album out. And,
cool.
Get a chance to talk to him, and we'll have him on the show next week. In upcoming weeks, we've got Simon Wright, who has played with AC/DC and Dio. We'll talk to him about the new Dio releases. We're going to have David Ellefson on again.
Cool.
Also, Ron Keel's going to come back and join us on the show.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, and you know what? He has so much more music than just Right to Rock. You know what?
No, really?
You don't think?
Yeah, he does. I think we had a couple of his albums on before, and he's good, man. Yeah, I always liked him. He's talented.
And he's good dude, too.
Yeah.
So looking forward to having him on the show. Want to thank, once again, Mike Tramp for coming on the show.
Yeah, that was cool. Good interview.
What's that?
That was a good interview, dude.
Thank you.
You're good at it.
Thanks. I've been trying to get, work on it for a couple of years.
Yeah.
He was telling me about maybe some rescheduled dates and one in Milwaukee coming up in October. So if they let us all get back together by October, I think I might go see that show.
That'd be cool. Very cool.
Yeah, you're going to be at Pottawatomie from what he told me.
Awesome.
Next week, Mitch Perry on the show. Just keep staying safe, people. We'll get through this sooner or later, but, Jerry and I will kind of keep trying to bring our ignorance to you each and every week.
Try to give you a couple hours of not having to think about, hear about it.
Exactly.
Something else.
amen to that, brother. Until next week, as we always say, please don't drink and drive.
Smoke and fly.
Peace.